Good evening. How is everyone? I'm again with you with a new topic. Today's topic is pronouns. So, let's define pronouns first. Pronouns are the words that are used in place of nouns. For example, I, we, you, he, she, his, her, their, them, myself, who, these, all these are pronouns. Let's classify them. See, types of the pronouns are personal pronouns, possessive pronouns, demonstrative pronouns, interrogative pronouns, reflexive pronouns, emphatic pronouns, relative pronouns, distributive pronouns, reciprocal pronouns, and indefinite pronouns. There will be instances when you will come across teachers who will teach emphatic pronouns and reflexive pronouns in the same group. That is also correct, because emphatic pronouns are part of reflexive pronouns. There is not much difference. They are part of reflexive. So they can be taught with them, they can be taught separately, it's all the same. Let's cover them up one by one. Let's take up personal pronouns first. Personal pronouns. Personal pronouns are those pronouns which replace name of person or things. They replace names of persons or things. This clearly indicates that they can be used as subject or object. Therefore, the uses of personal pronouns can be, they can be used as subject or as object. If we classify them in separate categories, then the speakers can be in three categories, the subjects can be in three categories, and they can be divided into first person, second person, and third person. The first person pronouns are I, we, second person, you, third person, he, she, it, they. But all these can be used only as subject. For using them as object, in the objective case, I will be me, we, us, you, of course, as subject, you, as object also it is you. Third person pronouns, he as subject, him as object, she as subject, her as object, it as subject, they as subject, them as object. See, personal pronouns that play the role of subject in a sentence are these, and the personal pronouns that play the role of objects
he becomes him, she becomes her, it remains it, and they becomes them. Now,
I, me, we, us, you, yours, he, him, she, her, it, they, and them. So all these are collectively taken together are personal pronouns. Now, second, possessive pronouns. Possessive pronouns are those which show possession or ownership. The book lying there is mine, and those on the table are hers. These words, mine and hers, indicate possession. So possessive pronouns are mine, ours, yours, his, hers, theirs. Before I take up the next one, let me tell you one thing, that there is always a confusion. When we were students, we came across this confusion, and even sometimes teachers get confused. When you are students, you are bound to be confused between the possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. See, sometimes they are understood to be, often they are confused to be the same. But there is a difference between the possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. Basically, three differences can be noted. Possessive pronouns show possession by standing instead of nouns. They replace nouns. They are not used with nouns. They instead replace them. When they are used, nouns are not required. That is the major difference. The possessive adjectives indicate possession by qualifying a noun. The possessive adjectives are used with the noun, whereas the possessive pronouns are used instead of a noun. This is the major difference. Possessive pronoun ko noun ki jagah par use karte hai, jabki possessive adjective unko replace nahi karte, balki wo unko qualify karte hai, wo noun ke saath hi use kiye jate hai. This is the major difference between possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. The second difference is they replace nouns. This I have already told you. Whereas, look here. The book lying there is mine. Mine. This clearly has replaced the noun. The noun is not required with it. But if I say my book, my requires a noun, that is book. So this is the basic difference. Mine, my book, hers,
her book. So hers is the possessive pronoun and her is the possessive adjective. Mine is the possessive pronoun and my is the possessive adjective. I hope I have made it pretty clear to you. Let's proceed further now. See, if you can have them in a table, the possessive pronouns, mine, yours, his, hers, ours, theirs, whereas the possessive adjectives are my, your, his, her, our, their, its. So this is the basic difference. Let's take up demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronouns are words that indicate noun in a sentence. This is the pen. I was looking for. I was looking for. This is the pen I was looking for. This replaces completely the noun. This is the reason. This is a pronoun. Mind you, this is also used as demonstrative adjective. When it is used as demonstrative adjective, in that case, this will be used with a noun. This pen is beautiful. So when I say this pen, here, this is adjective. It qualifies the noun pen. But in this case, this is the pronoun because it does not require any noun with it. It has completely replaced the noun. This is the basic difference between a pronoun and an adjective. Although this is used in both. This can be a pronoun. This can be adjective. But when it is used as pronoun, as demonstrative pronoun, it replaces the noun completely. What are the uses of demonstrative pronouns? They are used to point out people or things they stand for. This is my watch. They are also used to separate the category. Those are not mine. Those. So we have separated those with these. That is a separate category. This pen is mine. Those are not mine. They are also used when a statement or solution is referred to. This is what I said. This is what I said. So here, this refers to a statement or a solution. This is what I told you. Interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns are those pronouns that ask questions. Who is at the door? See, the uses of the interrogative pronouns here, who is used as a subject? And the object of the verb or preposition. In this case, it is a subject. And in this case, to whom? It is the object of the verb. The subject, the object. Okay. Interrogative pronouns are also used like whose. It is used to indicate possession. and used for persons and things both. Who is used only for the persons, whereas whose is used for both, for persons as well as things. There is one man missing, whose hasn't arrived, whose, which is used for persons or thing both. Which of these is the road to your house? Let's take up reflexive pronouns. Reflexive pronouns are those which reflect upon or go back. They bounce back, they reflect back, they go back to the subject. He hurt himself. He hurt himself. So himself reflects back on the subject. When the subject or object of the verb is the same person or thing, like I hurt myself, they are also used after verb preposition to clarify which person or thing we are talking. She is very happy with herself. She is very happy with herself. There is another kind of pronouns, that is emphatic pronouns. See, emphatic pronouns are basically reflexive pronouns. They are not a separate category. Sometimes the reflexive pronouns are used for emphasis. When the reflexive pronouns are used for emphasis, they are termed as emphatic pronouns. I myself cooked the food. I myself taught the class. So, this emphasizes. This is merely used, this is simply used for emphasis, and therefore this reflexive pronoun here becomes emphatic. And these are also used for emphasizing the nouns. The next category is relative pronouns. Relative pronouns are pronouns that are used to join phrases or a clause with another in a sentence. Who, whose, whom, which, and that. All these are used for joining. We have already learnt about connectors, conjunctions, and we have learnt them there. So they are used for connecting, they are used for joining. Who and whom are used for persons only. The little girl was guided by the teacher whom she truly admired. Here, whom stands for the teacher. Whose is used for both persons and things. The chair whose color is blue. So whose is used for both. Now let's talk about distributive pronouns. Distributive pronouns denote persons or things taken as single or in group. Each of you must be present on the occasion. They refer to the whole amount, both, all, or to separate items, every, each, either, neither. If I say neither of you, or I may say either of you. So all these are distributive pronouns. Let's talk about reciprocal pronouns. Reciprocal pronouns refer to pronouns that indicate action going on in one direction and also in the opposite direction. It is vice versa. See, we should help one another in crisis. We should help one another in crisis. Ram and Shyam helped each other, one another. These are used where a subject consisting two or more people, beings or things has been mentioned in the main clause. Each other, one another. The basic thing that we must remember is each other is used for two persons. One another is used for more than two. Whenever we have more than two, we use one another. Distribute these sweets. You should help one another in crisis. Distribute. Okay. Now, the indefinite pronouns are the pronouns that refer to one or more unspecified beings, objects or places. I have bought everything you might need for the journey. So everything in this sentence, everything is indefinite pronoun. Let's take a list of indefinite pronouns. You may make a note of all these pronouns. The list of indefinite pronouns: all, each, one, someone, any, many, other, something, another, no one, several, everybody, anybody, none, some, everyone, anyone, fifth, more, everything, anything, little, somebody, nothing. You must go through this list. You must go through all the types of pronouns. You must be very careful while studying the personal pronouns, the possessive pronouns, the difference between the possessive pronouns and the possessive adjectives, and of course the difference between while studying distributive, the difference between one another and each other. We must also know how to use both, all. We must also clearly know the difference between one another and each other while studying reciprocal pronouns. And we must make a list while studying indefinite pronouns. Keep coming to me for any doubts. Thank you for joining. I shall again be with you tomorrow at the same time with a new topic. Till then, it's goodbye from me.